One Reaction with Levy, and we are back with our second episode of the Daily One Reaction. Last night I called the LeBron and the Lakers winning. I was completely wrong on that. LeBron and co. lost by 30. He admitted it too. He said we got our ass beat. Hopefully he maybe has a Superman act coming in game 6 and 7. But the biggest news of the day does not come in LA, it comes in Boston. After the loss last night, Danny Ainge, the president of basketball operations, rumored to be out, is now out. And guess who replaces his spot as the president of basketball operations? The current head coach, Brad Stevens, in one of the most shocking moves of the year, I think, in the front office in the NBA. And his top coaches right now that he's looking at, he's going to lead the search. You got Jason Kidd, Lloyd Pierce, now Evan Turner rumored to go there. So those are the three guys as of now, right when Brad Stevens got the job. But to dive into this a bit deeper, we knew Ainge was on his way out, and we knew it could be we didn't know who it would be. And Brad Stevens, a very unprecedented move to bring a coach up from a college coach to go to a head coach in the NBA to now a GM. It's very unprecedented, and I don't know if I like the move. Do we know if Brad Stevens can work the cap? Can he do all this stuff? He's going to be inexperienced, and time will tell, and he's got a lot of big decisions to make. Kemba Walker, what do you do with him, with his contract? Evan Fournier, the new acquisition, do you re-sign him? And how do you create cap space to go get that third guy that Kemba Walker hasn't been because of his knees and he's just too small? And I don't think they're going to win a championship with those three guys at your top three. I think you need another guy alongside Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown. Okay, now with that over, it's not over. It's going to be a lot coming out in the next couple days about what the Boston Celtics will do with their franchise. Let's go to the NBA. And we'll start with that Nets-Bucks game. Season lost last night, and people are tweeting on Twitter that it was Kyrie Irving that sent the Boston Celtics into a dumpster fire. They won 123-109. Now we get the Nets-Bucks, the series I've been waiting for a while. I think this is the matchup. If you're Brooklyn, you're looking, okay, who's the team that can beat us? Lakers? They're not looking too good right now. I think it's the Bucks. I think they have the best chance to beat the Brooklyn Nets right now. They can defend Harden or Kyrie with Holiday, top perimeter defender in the league. They have the size to block the driving lanes against Kevin Durant. You got Giannis. He's the guy that can kind of rise up with Giannis in terms of length-wise. So I think the Bucks match up pretty well, and I could definitely see them winning the series. The question will become, pick your poison with Drew Holiday guarding one. I would guard James Harden. And I would let Kyrie Irving be one-on-one because Harden creates so well. We'll see what happens. I think it's going to be a very close series. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. And I think it comes down to how Chris Middleton kind of plays as that third guy for Milwaukee. Let's move on to probably the best game of the night last night yet, and probably the playoffs so far. Blazers, Nuggets. I mean, are you kidding? Dame has 55, but they still lose. I mean, Dame was unbelievable. Jokic also had 38, 11, and 9, but 55 and you still lose, and now the Nuggets are in prime position to win the series. But I would not count out Dame. But if the Blazers lose, this is something I'm going to bring up. If they lose this series against no Murray, and your supporting cast going 15 for 47 tonight, is it fair to wonder, is Dame maybe the next disgruntled superstar in the NBA? I mean, his supporting cast did not help him tonight. He scored 55 points, still did not win. If they lose in the first round, I think there's a case where Damian Lillard comes out and says, I'm not happy. I want to win. And he right now, I don't think he can win in Portland. CJ McCollum off last night. You have Carmelo Anthony as your third best player. They don't have a guy besides Nurkic to guard Jokic. And once he got in foul trouble, it was over, and Jokic had his way. So you can't do it all by yourself. So it's going to be interesting to see if they lose this first-round series, what happens in this offseason with Damian Lillard. Yes, he's under contract, but that doesn't mean he can't pull a James Harden. For the Nuggets, Jokic's accomplishment, I think it solidifies to the fans. Not as much to the guys that watch Nikola Jokic play every day, but to the fans that think, I don't know if Jokic can be MVP. You saw last night, he's the MVP. He's spectacular with scoring, scored 38. Great passing. He took out Nurkic 24 minutes in. And then he had Cantor and Anthony, and he had his way last night. That's why he's the MVP. And if he wins this series, Porter didn't play particularly well. If he wins the series over Dame without Jamal Murray, I think it'll be very impressive for his resume going forward. And now let's move on to LA Phoenix. Of course, you know the score, 115-85. Booker to 30. Payne stepping up. He's been terrific all series long. He had 16, and now the Suns team is in prime position to move on in the second round. I think there's an excuse now for the Lakers and LeBron James, and of course there's an excuse if they lose. AD's health, I mean, it pretty much decided it. You saw, remember game four, heading into game four, Lakers up 2-1, favored by 6.5 at home. Then AD gets hurt. Now the series has completely flipped. It feels over, but I'm never going to count out LeBron James because we know not to. But you got an excuse now. And AD's health is a major issue going forward for this LA team. They got to get him right. He's got to work better. Stretching, offseason, I don't know, but he's got to get more healthy throughout the year, more available for LeBron because he's getting older and older each year. Tonight's games, let's move on. And I think there's four games tonight. A lot of interesting stuff. I'll give you my thoughts. We got the Wizards, 76ers. So the 76ers are favored by 6. No Joel Embiid tonight. He is doubtful, but now just since ruled out. He has a small meniscus tear in his knee. It's not believed to be serious, which is good for the 76ers. But looking in regards to tonight, I think the key for the Sixers is Tobias Harris. How can he be the guy on the wing to lead Philly to a win? Because I think this backcourt, I think it's pretty even. I'm going to give the edge to Wizards. Westbrook and Beal, they kind of found something in game four. I expect them to play pretty well, and you're going to have to take out Simmons in that crunch time, or they're just going to do the same thing and foul him. I mean, that's a real issue, and that will kind of open up one of those wings for offensively in crunch time for the Wizards. So I think the Wizards kind of have the advantage. I think Gafford plays much better without Embiid. You saw it again in game four. When Embiid went out, Gafford played really well. I think this is a very tough spot for Philly. I don't want to pencil them in just yet. The Wizards have not quit all year. They got two stars in Westbrook and Beal. As much as we hate on Russell Westbrook, he's still a star. Yes, there's no Bertans or Embiid, so I think it would be a lower scoring game, but I think the Wizards got a real shot because Westbrook and Beal can be the two best players on the floor unless Harris plays really well. All right, and then we got the New York Knicks tonight on TNT. Hawks-Knicks. The Knicks are actually favored, down 3-1. Can the Hawks close it out? And I think they should be the favorites. I disagree with this line a little bit. The Hawks are the better team. But I think the Knicks can do a couple things that can kind of change things up for them. And it's on the offensive side of the basketball. It's MSG. You're going to probably make more shots and get your role players going. And you've seen that the Knicks offense has kind of struggled a little bit, right? And I think it's because they're hiding. The Hawks have the ability to hide Trae Young on Reggie Bullock. And Nate McMillan's a master of a defensive coach, so he knows how to do that. And that's allowing them to double Randle. It's just, you can just stick, and they don't have a defensive matchup that the Knicks can take advantage of. I think you need to switch it up and take out Bullock. He's been terrific. He was terrific in game two, but I think it's time for Quickly. He would be my preference because he can play defense a little bit more, or Burks to come in so they can't hide Young. If you can't hide Young, then I think Quickly or Burks is a shot creator that can really go to the rim, and I think if the Knicks execute, that will allow Barrett. So you get three creators on the floor. Barrett, Rose, and then Quickly or Burks. You start with Quickly and Burks, then they have to double because Trae Young can't handle that, and then you get it to your better players. Rose has had that one-on-one matchup versus Bogdanovich, and I think you have enough creators that will kind of take the pressure off of Randle. I think he has a better game if this happens. So I think that's the move you do if you're the Knicks offensively. Defensively, this is why you put in Emmanuel Quickly. He's the only guy that can kind of, sort of, maybe stay in front of him. I'm not putting Alec Burks on him. That would kind of cause defensive miscues for the Knicks. But I'm saying crunch time, I think it's time to play Quickly. We knew coming in that Quickly needed to play well. He needs to have that Quickly game. He needs to have that 15 points in 20 minutes for the Knicks to have a chance tonight. And I think they could do it. I don't know if it's possible. I don't know if Thibs is going to make the adjustments, but we'll see tonight. Then we got the Grizzlies, Jazz, NBA TV 9:30. I think the Jazz have a clear advantage in the series. Morant needs to be spectacular. Brooks can't be in foul trouble, and Jaren Jackson has to do something. I don't see it happening. I think Jazz have three of the best four players in the series, and they win tonight. 10 p.m. TNT Mavericks Clips, -7.5 for the Clippers, had a 2-2. Two games ago, we were saying the Clippers are done. Now it feels like they're the long favorite. They're favored by 7.5, which is ridiculous. Doncic is probable, Ibaka out, but I think it's all for the Mavs. It's all about their role players hitting shots. I don't know if they can keep that same percentage up, and I think it's just too hard for Doncic, not 100%, to really take advantage. Leonard, George, I think they're playing much better now. I like the Clippers tonight, and I think they get this game 5 win and win this in 6. All right, so let's move to the NHL. Last night, Lightning 2-1 over Carolina despite losing the shot battle 32-15. That's called a goaltender defense alert. Andrei Vasilevskiy showing why he's a top goaltender in this league. Tonight, we got 7:30 p.m. Canadians, Jets, battle of offense, defense. But I think the Jets have an upper hand in this series. Halabuck and this D are just as good as the Montreal defense. I think they just have a better offense. So I like the Jets in this series. We'll see what happens. Game one tonight, 7:30 NBCSN. 10 p.m. Golden Knights and Avalanche. This is Avalanche are heavy favorites after game one. It was a blowout, 100%. And Robin Leonard's out, and now the starting goaltender's back for Vegas. Can Fleury save the day? You knew that game was going to be tough for the Vegas Golden Knights to win. They got blown out. I think they come back with vengeance tonight. I think Fleury plays really well. I think this is a much better game for Vegas. They're not on. They don't have a rest issue. They were on 2 days. They were on a day or 2 days of rest while Colorado was well rested. I don't think that's an issue in this game. They get their goalie back. I think there's a shot. If you're saying, okay, where's the game that Golden Knights can kind of steal a game from Colorado? This is the game. I could definitely see an upset. And one final thing, Coach K is retiring after next year, which is very surprising news. So this year will probably be dedicated to Coach K in college basketball. So one reaction with Levy, the Daily One Reaction.